When we do research, more often than not, it involves more than just popping some questions into your favorite search engine. For complex questions, you need to have a clear objective, plan out how you're going to get your answer, gather data sources, figure out what the data is telling you, and only then can you generate an answer. Multi-agentic systems follow some variation of this same pattern, but instead of one person doing everything, different specialized agents collaborate to automate this research process at scale. But what is this research process? Well, in general, it follows these five steps. Step one is to define the research objective. Then step two is to make a plan. How are we going to conduct the research? Then in step three, we need to, of course, gather our data from various sources. Then in step four, we need to refine our insights. And then lastly, in step five, we need to generate an answer. So let's take a closer look at how a multi-agentic framework accomplishes this. If you're a data scientist, developer, researcher, or any knowledge worker, you're probably aware that open source frameworks like LangGraph, CrewAI, or LangFlow provides tools for easily defining multi-agentic workflows for research agents that follow these five steps tailored to your specific field of study. So, starting, for example, at step one, one agent in the system could be responsible for defining the research goal. Let's see, one little agent here. And he accepts a query from a user. And from this query, he's seeking to answer questions like, what problem is the research aiming to solve? What kind of output should be generated? Is it raw data, a summary, a detailed report? This step is critical because, just like in human research, clarity in defining objectives leads to better results. Onward to step two, defining a research plan. The role of this agent is to create a structured roadmap, which could include generating sub-questions to break down the larger research goal, creating a research template to organize findings systematically, or suggesting initial data sources such as academic papers, code repositories, or databases to use as part of the plan. Here, you actually have some choices in the implementation. You could have separate agents, which might make sense, which would create oversight and early review and refinement of the research plan, or you could have the same agent from step one, which is the keep it simple approach. CrewAI, for example, allows us to define specialized agent roles, and each of these agents could have an appropriate LLM to use for that role. So here, we might have an agent specialized as a research strategist. And this research strategist could be used for definition and planning. Or we may have another agent defined, and his role could be data miner. This brings us to our all-important step of gathering data from various sources. Now the real research begins. A search agent or multiple retrieval agents can pull from academic papers, online databases, research repositories, or even structured API calls to your own internal knowledge sources, custom search tools. This system may employ vector-based retrieval from your data sources and search optimization to enhance information discovery. Remember though, safety first. I'm gonna draw a caution sign. A misleading paper is worse than no paper at all. AI systems are vulnerable to data poisoning, misinformation, and manipulation. And so we must ensure the accuracy and trustworthiness of the final output, especially at this phase. So we need to provide our data miner with a list of prioritized, reliable data sources. Prioritized knowledge sources. For example, a medical research agent should rank peer-reviewed journals higher than a random blog post. A legal research system could be limited to officially approved repositories of approved legal case histories, for example. Which brings us to step four. We want to refine our insights as we are collecting this data. Here, we could have an agent, and his role could be defined as data analyst. Because, of course, data collection isn't enough. We need analysis and validation as well. This is where knowledge sources, knowledge stores, retrieval augmented generation, and fact-checking agents come into play. This agent's role is to examine the data coming in to see, are the sources credible? Are the insights contradictory? Does the data fit together? The data coming in fit together, and does it contradict the prioritized knowledge sources that it was provided? Again, safety first. Designing validation layers can help to detect inconsistencies or bias sources. It can help to filter out misinformation or prevent hallucinations so as to confidently highlight key takeaways. There's also the opportunity at this step to request more data and changes to the research plan. So there may be some recursion happening with the research strategist. Which brings us to step five, where finally we get to generate an answer. Finally, the agent compiles everything into a structured, human-readable format. This agent is our research writer. And using specialized fine-tuned LLMs that are great for writing academic or technical content, this agent could help to generate the ideal output of the research. Here, it's important to define benchmarks and tests to measure the performance of this agent as well as the others to the stated tasks. Easier said than done. But open source frameworks such as IT Bench can help us to accomplish this with some tailoring. So the final output should lead to positive outcomes. AI research agents can accelerate how we explore knowledge, but only if we build them responsibly. We know there's a difference between productivity, more papers per unit time, and fruitfulness, quality research papers free from bias and for the common good. So multi-agentic AI research isn't just about speed. It's also about trust and safety as well.